you for tuning in to the Beacon 5, 5 Things You Don't Know About Marketing this week. My name is Roger Gallegos. I am the founder and CEO of Beacon Marketing. This week we'll be talking about how you can turn leads into sales. This is really a continuation of the video we did last week, which was about capturing leads. When you capture a lead, that's only part of the process. All you do is make the person aware of your company and get them into your funnel. What this video is all about, what we're going to be talking about today, is taking the next step, which is turning potential customers into paying ones. Because once you're able to do that, then you can really see your business take off. Because a CRM full of potential customers that aren't buying anything doesn't make much sense. It really isn't going to help. You really need to find a way to turn those potential clients into paying ones. So the first thing you could do, the first step, a way you could get better at turning leads into sales, is use targeted content. Now, what I mean by that is use your content that actually speaks to people and their specific needs. For instance, I have a broad audience. I talk to several different types of clients. What I'm working on, what I'm trying to do with my own list, is go through and segment them so that when I send out an email, I can be really strategic and specific about, okay, I'm going to focus on this type of client or where these people are. And it could be people who are just starting out marketing, or it could even be a group of people that I met at an event and I say, hey, it was nice seeing you at this event. Let's get together here. Let's do this. I'm nurturing them in a way that's very specific because I reference where I met them, or I talked to, let's say, some medical clients or potential clients I met in the medical field and said, hey, you're a doctor of the practice. Let me show you the way that I've helped other doctors work and grow their business. Those type of things. You want to be able to identify the segments in your list, break them off, and use targeted content that's just for them because it's more personalized. You're speaking to them directly, you're addressing their specific solutions as opposed to just this broad sort of esoteric kind of thing that they should be aware of, because that's not going to generate the interest that you need. But if you're actually speaking directly to them and addressing a problem that's, or a pain point that's specific to them, you're going to turn more heads. You're going to get them to act. It's going to make it easier for them to act and pay attention to you. So the first thing you want to do is use targeted content. Next is you want to focus on multiple touches. As I've said before in other videos, it takes multiple touches. It takes about 8 to 12 touches for a person or a business to make a purchase. The best way to do that is use a multi-channel approach. You want to use email, some social media, your website, those type of things. So when people are doing research for you, they start seeing you other places. They see an email from you. Then they see a blog on your website. And maybe they see a post that you put on social media or a video that you put on YouTube. Those type of things. And then they just start kind of becoming more aware of you. And then eventually, when that need that you identified, when that pain point gets too great for them to ignore, then you're already top of mind. You already have done all those touches. Because a lot of times people don't buy, not because they're not interested. It's because either the need, they don't have the money, or the need has not been great enough at that time. Eventually the need will be great enough. So for instance, if you're a roofer, somebody may have a hole in their roof, but they're making it work. Until it rains really bad, the hole gets buried, and they just have water pouring down, then that need has gotten too great. And if you've done the work of staying in touch with them, then they'll be like, you know what, I'm going to call ABC Roofing and get this taken care of. That's why you want to use those multiple touches and use that multi-channel approach. So that's number two, focus on multiple touches. Third is, time is really of the essence. What I mean by that is a follow up in a timely manner. This is for if someone asks a question or if you meet someone. Like I use the example of following up after an event. For instance, I attended an event, a virtual event, 2 months ago. The very next day, I had an email scheduled for the people that I personally interacted with, and I sent a follow up email. If I were to send that email now, they're like, what is this guy doing? It's been 2 months because life goes on. Or if someone asks me a question on Facebook or on Instagram or wherever, I want to be able to respond to them ASAP, because if I wait a week or 2 weeks, chances are they've already gone elsewhere to answer the question. So if your customers are interacting with you, follow up in a timely manner. If you want to follow up after meeting somebody, again, follow up within a day or two to so you may let them know that, hey, this is a priority. They make them feel good. And also, they're in the right state of mind, because they may just be, what are you talking about? And it's been two months since I talked to you. Those type of things. You want to make sure you follow up in a timely manner. So number three, time is of the essence. Number four is make it personal. This is really tied into that targeted content. You want to use their name and their email. Try to reference things that apply to them. Now, if you're sending out like a group email, it's very hard to make it personal on a one-to-one basis, but you know, just about any email software allows you to enter the name, you know, like fill in the blank name, and it pulls their name from the records in the CRM. So you want to do that. You want to be able to pull in their name, so you're speaking directly to them, and then speak in general terms by, again, making it about what they're experiencing, because chances are, if one doctor or one restaurant owner or one person's having a problem, the whole industry has that same type of pain point. So if you're being, I call it general specific. So if you're being general about a specific problem, they're going to recognize that, and you have a greater chance of getting them to pay attention and eventually calling you. So you want to make it personal, not only in name, but about what they're experiencing, even if you do that general specific type approach. Number five, this is an important one. This is where a lot of people fail. As I say, be persistent and consistent. Now, let me explain those two different things. The first thing is you want to continuously follow up. You don't want to do it in an annoying fashion. You don't want to just, you know, keep sending out, you know, 10 Facebook messages, so all they're seeing is Beacon Marketing posts again, Beacon Marketing, because they're eventually going to be like, okay, I get it, and stop following you. But you want to be persistent, so you're actually just staying on the radar and getting those touches in that we talked about before. And then you want to be consistent in the way you do things. You want to be consistent in your branding, in the colors, in your logo. You want to be consistent even in the days and times that you post something, because people get used to that. Like, I post my blogs and my videos on Friday mornings. I'm hoping people recognize that and see it and say, you know what, Beacon Marketing just came out a new video. It's Friday morning. I'm having my bowl of cereal. I want to sit down and watch it and check it out. There's a couple of video things that I'm subscribed to that they, when they come out, I know when they come out, and I actually, it's not that I plan my day around them, but I plan certain actions around them. So I say, okay, when this video comes out, I'm going to sit down and clear my email. I have the video on another screen, so I'm kind of listening to and paying attention to while I take care of all my spam and junk email. Those type of things people will do, and they stay, another way to stay on someone's radar. So be persistent, be consistent. Number five. Quick recap. Use targeted content. Remember, one size does not fit all. Focus on getting multiple touches. Use a multi-channel approach to get those touches in. Time is of the essence. Follow up in a timely manner, whether it's from an event that you attended or a question that somebody has on social media. Make it personal. Use their name and potentially speak to a general specific problem. And then be persistent and consistent. Don't be annoying, but you want to become trusted. You want to be able to have them believe in you. And the way to do that is if you're consistent with the messaging that you put out, and you're persistent in how you do so, and you do it on a regular fashion. So that's it for me today. Let me know what you think about this. How do you turn leads into sales? What tactics work best for you? What things haven't worked for you? Let me know that. As always, please like, share, comment, subscribe, all that fun stuff. I have not settled on a topic for next week, but it's going to be a great one, so please stay tuned for that. This has been the Beacon 5, 5 Things You Need to Know About Marketing this week. Thank you so much for your time and for your attention. I greatly appreciate it. My name is Roger Gallegos. I am the founder and CEO of Beacon Marketing. I'll see you next week. You have a wonderful rest of your day and week. Talk to you later. Bye.